Father in heaven, we thank you again. Thank you for bringing Papa to join you this time. We pray that as many of walks in here, walk with her. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
This is the day that the Lord has made. This man, I'm not content for bringing you a bole. Look out for the best man. He's a very good type of man. I'm giving him 100%. Hallelujah. Amen. The mentor was almost there. Praise the Lord. Amen. Papa Bishop, you're welcome to celebrate this service. And we shall now begin the service. Stand with me on page 3 of our order of service. Page 3. Brothers and sisters, we have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Peter and Miriam, to ask His blessing on them, and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was Himself a guest at the wedding in Cana of Galilee, and through His Holy Spirit, He is with us now. The Holy Scriptures teaches us that marriage is a gift from God in creation, and a way of His grace, and a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife, they give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, that they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with the church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love through the joy of their bodily union, and to strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given that they may have children and be blessed in caring for them and bringing them up in accordance with God's will, to His praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to each other, and they begin a new life together in the community. It is a way of life that all should honor, and it must not be undertaken carelessly or lightly or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is the way of life created and allowed by God that Peter and Miriam are to begin. They will each give consent to each other. They will hold hands and exchange sincere vows. And in token of this, they will give and receive a ring. Therefore, on their wedding day, we pray with them that strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill His purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone who knows any genuine reason why these two, Peter and Miriam, may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Oba kwenye songa yona, iruwele wanahayini, Peter and Miriam, okufumi lika na mufu wa uchuku, ujuge kati. I don't know what I'm saying. Peter and Miriam, I think the people standing are on official duty. So you have to relax. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give them a big hand clap. Now I turn to you, Peter and Miriam. The vows you are about to make are to be made in the name of God, who is judge of all and knows the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows any reason why you may not love the money, you declare it now. I begin with you, Peter. Is there any reason why you should not take Miriam as your wife?
No, no, no.
No, no, no. You can now know where the heart of the man is. You can know where the heart of the man is. Miriam, is there any reason why you should not take Peter as your husband? You declare it now.
There is no reason.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You clap for them. There is no reason. We are on page 4 and we are going to take their vows.
Annie Bain, you might be wedding a Roman woman. Annie Bain. Okay. Oh boy, I bet.
Annie Bain. That's it.
My father's a car. hands. Hold hands. Hold hands. You hold hands. Can hold your
hands. I, Peter Eka Colon.
Take you, Miriam Nyakecho.
Take you, Miriam Nyakecho.
Be my lawful wedding bride.
Be my lawful wedding bride.
My words will have and hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in
health. To love.
To love.
Respect.
Respect.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
According to
God's holy law.
This is my sincere prayer.
This is my sincere
prayer.
Let's pray for the wings.
Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let this wings be richer and clearer, as a symbol of unending love and faithfulness to remind them of the vows and the covenant they have made this day through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Miriam,
exactly. I give you this ring
of our marriage
with my body.
I honor you.
All that I am.
I give to you.
All that I have.
I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Our Father.
Son. Peter.
Peter.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Upon
my marriage.
With my body.
With my body.
I honor you.
I honor you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
Within the love.
Within the love.
Of God.
Of God.
Our Father.
Our Father.
Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
kiwandiko.
Oh, be with my name, you my
This is the word of the Lord.
Praise God.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
So our second reading is God's word from the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, from verse 22 to 23. Why shall we, the husbands, ask the Lord? 23. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church. His body of which he is the Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. 25. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word. 27. And present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle of any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as church love as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you also must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband.
I request that we shall all rise. And on page 9, affirm our faith in the Apostles' Creed. When we affirm our faith with the Apostles' Creed on page 9, together, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried, descended into hell, the third day rose again from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and is still at the right hand of the Father Almighty. From hence shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
for the
communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
Amen. I'm fine, brother. I'm going to have a reading.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
I want to begin by congratulating Peter and Miriam. Congratulations. Let's clap for them. I want to thank the best man at Metron for working with them again. Let's clap for them. I want to thank the groomsmen and the boys for working with them. I want to thank the maids and the flower gatherers for working with them. I want in a special way to appreciate the parents of Miriam. Parents of Miriam, just stand up and wave. Thank you very much. The parents of Peter. Abazandra Peter, will you be there? Yes, thank you very much. Then I want to appreciate the people, all the people came from the side of Peter. Just stand up and celebrate in your own style. Now it is time for revenge.
He loved us to his end, that he gave his own life, and he died shameful death on the cross, the death of a king. He came to his own, and his own did not love him, did not know him. He's the same Christ who cried on the cross, "Father, forgive them. Forgive them because they do not know what they're doing." What will now forgive to you? Peter, to say to your wife, as he said the other time, "I forgive you." Peter, just whisper, "I forgive you." Miriam can likewise say, "I forgive you." Your husband, not me. And for me, my duty is to pronounce the forgiveness of sins. May God bless you and keep you. May he forgive you of the past mistakes. May he see you alive again in a bouncing man. Hallelujah. Finally, these are hints about marriage. In 3 points. 1. What has joined you together is love of God. It unites the love of God. That through Christ the cross. Peter, should you find Miriam being molested, being handled, being mishandled by anybody else, as short as you are, tell the man who will die in you. You will die. And I will save the life of my wife. And if you don't have enough strength, be intelligent enough. I'm going to see how to make him to be blind. Pick the soil, put on his eyes, and then put him down. Save my life. As you give in your own. 2. If you will demonstrate the love I'm trying to explain to you, from now onwards, a sharp turn out. Let your tongue speak the words of love.
Thank you.
We thank you for their family. We thank you for their parents. We thank you for their relatives. We thank you for the choirs and for the entire congregation. We have not come to you empty-handed. Accept these offerings. Sanctify and bless them so that they can do well in your sanctuary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. We are entering the moment of intercessions. Choir, give us a short chorus as these people go on their knees, those who are able to kneel. that he can come here as I invite. I'll be doing the next day ceremony. Praise the Lord.
You in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Samson. And Samson is happy to come. As we welcome last Bandas with me to the community of Bandas. And from there, they have given you, they remember this gift when Peter knows you. You remember what you saw in there in the Lord's altar. So when you see that this gift, again you forgive and you continue. And the Lord will call it the Lord that I receive my blessing. They prayed for me at the altar and I'm going to be working for you. So you see, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.